I'm Michael, Mike Jr. In fact, there's two of us here. And largely I machine program and operate the two mills here alongside with my teammate, Dustin. He's operating the lathes. So TooHighPSI started off as a Fox body upgrade company. Basically after I'd been born and life had some changes, the company kind of died away for a little bit. And then when I was finishing up college, decided to bring back the name and try to do what we loved again. So specifically, we're largely focused around port injection kits right now. So with the newest generation of LT or GM V8 motors, they're all direct injected. So we tried to introduce a cost-effective, super easy to install way of introducing port injection into your car. Now it's gonna allow you to run different types of fuel. In our case, we largely run E85. It lets you, run a little more timing, more boost, get that more power out of your motor that you want without having to break the bank. It's kind of funny, my dad had called me one day and said there was an opportunity for the VF4 we have over there. Decided to go forward with it. We thought we'd just make our own car parts with it, make our own upgrades as we went along, and I ended up really enjoying working on that VF4. Kept practicing with it, getting better at using it, and sure enough, we started releasing some of our own products and people had interest in them, and it's grown into our machine shop having, four machines now and the whole product line we currently have. So the pallet pool we bought for two large reasons. Obviously, we want to increase production and get some nighttime running out of it. We have some parts that have, 2 hour cycles. If I can get each pallet to have a 2 hour cycle, I'm getting 8 hours of runtime overnight. But the other thing was keeping a vertical style mill was a nice stepping stone for me to figure out the pallet pool. So the VF4, I was pretty comfortable with that. I was comfortable with the fact that I could run a VF2 effectively while also juggling the pallet pool as well. One thing that's going to change in your mindset is the machine almost needs to always be continually running, right? In the case of a pallet pool, I can always be setting something up in the load station to keep the machine running. So getting your timing right for that is going to be very critical. Deciding how you're going to set up the pallets. In our case, it made sense. The first part we released that came off the VF2 was our valve covers. They have four critical parts in them. That means I delegated each pallet to have one part of the valve cover. So every day I was getting multiple full kits of valve covers rather than all of one piece, all the next piece. The other thing that changed my mindset too, and it's luckily translating back to the VF4 now, is getting as many parts on the table as possible. So when you get all those parts there, you can hit that runtime. If you get now an hour instead of the 30 minutes, that's an hour where I could have, been programming the next part. Well, I think we have some pretty exciting plans going forward. We have a couple more parts we want to finish in the LT arena and move into the LS arena a little bit. I think there's always room for improvement and development, and that's kind of what we continue to do. These are parts, we get to use every day, so might as well make them as best as we can and enjoy them.